Will she be willing to donate her eggs if you and Chris ever want to have kids?
First off, I just want to thank everybody on Patreon for supporting this channel. Without further ado, this is a Q&A I did with my sister Jessica. We had a blast. We filmed for over an hour. So what I'm going to do is make more than one video, and this is Q&A part one.
I'm with my sister Jessica. She's about to graduate high school, which is a pretty big deal.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to go to what college?
UNC in Greeley.
Okay, we're going to get right into the Q&A. Thank you for the questions. When did you come out to each other?
I don't know. Did mom tell you?
You want to know what happened?
Oh, God.
Mom's like, I have something to tell you about Jessica. And I was like, is she a lesbian? And she's like, how'd you know? I was like, it was just a guess.
One thing I do remember is, like, I think we were in the back of mom's minivan. And you're showing Ashley this video of you and Chris kissing. And I saw it from, like, the back. And I was like, what is that? I was so confused. Because, like, I don't think you'd come
So that's
out.
When you found out.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't know at the time. I was like, that's odd, but whatever.
You came out just recently, like a year or two ago?
That was my freshman year. So
wow, that's so young. Do they treat you well?
Actually, I don't even tell people most of the time. Like, sometimes, like, I'll be like, oh, yeah, by the way, hey, here's this thing. And they're like, yeah, okay, whatever. And then just continue on. And then some are just like, whoa, wait, really? Like, you couldn't even tell. And I'm like, okay, cool. Like, it's just not something that I announce to everyone.
Makes sense. Because there's more to your identity.
Yeah, I also just don't give a shit.
Yeah. What did you do as kids that annoyed each other about each other?
This would be more of a question for you than me.
Well, the thing is, she was so young. We have a pretty decent sized age gap.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember hanging out with her all the time. She was actually a big tomboy. She would jump on the trampoline with me. We were really, really close when we were younger. And then I moved out and it just kind of changed things.
Yeah. I don't know. What about me annoyed you?
Nothing really.
Really? Oh. Is it harder for a woman to be accepted than a gay guy?
It's hard to know because we're not even in each other's shoes. I was working a blue collar job and there was a lesbian there that was working and all the guys were like, oh, she's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
She works hard, she's pretty cool, but a gay guy, they weren't so happy about.
So then I guess I'd say it might be easier.
But it's probably situational too.
Yeah. What do you have in common and is there any difference between straight and gay girls? P.S. Hello from Russia. I don't know. Again, living apart is what's so hard.
Sometimes we do like the same songs. I liked Adele. I liked Khalid. Is there any difference between straight and gay girls?
Because
you're educating me right now.
I don't know. It's like
I have no idea.
I'd say for Wyoming, there's not really much of a difference.
Because most of your friends are probably straight, right?
Yeah. But what is my favorite room at the B&B? That's also a hard one. Because I haven't stayed in all of them, but I've stayed in a lot of them. I don't know, I've always liked the apartment in the garden house. What's my first impression of Chris when I knew that you're dating him?
Yeah, that's a good question.
So, well, that would kind of go back to the video of you and him kissing. I don't know, he seemed cool, he seemed fine. I didn't think much of it.
You have to admit, Chris is a cool guy.
Yeah, I love Chris, he's so cool.
What's one thing either one of you guys would change about something you've done in your past? I probably wouldn't have gotten a DUI. That really bummed me out.
I'm a pretty good kid, honestly.
I was a bad kid, kind of.
Maybe just like, I don't know.
You don't want to tell that story.
Well,
you don't want to tell on yourself either, because mom might watch this video.
Well, yeah. It's not even like that. Like, I haven't done really anything. I'm just like, I don't know. What I would say
spinning
is not interesting. I don't want to throw mom under the bus.
Okay, you want to move on then?
Yeah, I don't really have an answer to that. I'm a good kid.
What was your favorite thing to do with each other growing up? Love you long time. Jumping on the tramp.
Yeah, or that playing in the fort.
Or playing in the
or
fort.
Or swinging on the rope.
In what ways do you feel a lesbian relationship is different from a gay relationship? I have no idea. Like, I've never been in a lesbian relationship.
Yeah.
Have you been in a gay relationship? What kind of...
I mean, technically.
That's weird. How, like, a lesbian can be considered gay.
Yeah.
But, you know,
I mean, I know, like, I prefer the term gay. I just don't like the word lesbian for some reason. It's just, like, it's so much to say. Just say that you're gay. I don't know. It's just, like, I don't know. Anyways. Also, there's, like, the stereotype of, you know, lesbians moving really fast.
Oh, is there?
You know what U-hauling is?
No.
Oh. It's, like...
U-hauling?
Yeah. From what I understand, I've never, like, officially looked it up, so you can look it up...
Like
this.
Urban Dictionary?
Yeah, something like that. I don't know.
Want me to
but
look
it's
it
like,
up?
Yeah, look it up real quick. I don't want to get it wrong, but like, it's something like in a lesbian relationship is like moving fast, so then they move in really fast, like after like a very short amount of time being together.
I have heard that.
Yeah.
Lesbians move in together quick.
U-hauling. Make sure.
Packing up and moving in together after knowing each other in just 3 months.
Yeah, see? So like, I feel like that's what like...
And perhaps the greatest tradition in punchline in lesbian culture.
it's just the thing. I don't know why.
So I actually didn't know that was called U-hauling.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. I'm edumacated.
Mm-hmm.
Will she be willing to donate her eggs if you and Chris ever want to have kids? I summarized that.
I mean, I don't think it'd really be fair to you and Chris, though, because we don't look alike at all. If
be
you were
going
to get anything from anyone, I think it might be Ashley.
Why?
Just because your blood is closer, I don't know. Oh. You're a little more blood related than I am.
Well, we're still blood related.
Well, no, I know. I just
we have the same mom.
Yeah. I just mean with different dads. I don't mean for that to sound terrible. It's just like that's how it is, though.
Has it strengthened your relationship with her? Maybe in some underlying subconscious mm-hmm. level. I mean, we have a mutual respect and we understand something that like moms doesn't quite understand.
Yeah.
Having kids is different for you,
mm-hmm.
like it is for me.
Mm-hmm.
You'd have to adopt or have to like use your eggs.
Yeah, maybe give my eggs to you, I don't know.
When you're over 18.
Well, yeah. Who are some of your personal queer icons?
Maybe Ellen, I don't know. She's like one of the only queer people that I like really watch a lot. And by the way, I actually hate the word queer. I don't know why. I didn't grow up with that.
Yeah.
I grew up playing Smear the Queer. It was not a good thing to be a queer. Mm-hmm. It meant like you were gonna get tackled with a football and then you would have to like throw the football so you were not the queer anymore. It was not a good term.
Yeah. I don't have a problem with the word. It's just like, it's not in my vocabulary. So
it's used more in a negative way probably in Casper when I grew up.
I don't know. I like Queer Eye though. Have you seen that show on Netflix? I like a lot of the guys on there though.
Yeah, they're funny.
Yeah.
I like the cooking guy. What's his name?
Anthony?
Yeah, he's cool.
Mm-hmm. Hey guys, I do have a question. Who came out first and was it easier for you or your sister to come out knowing one of you was already out?
I came out way first.
Yeah, like way, way before me.
But it's because of the age difference.
Yeah. I'd say it was a lot easier for me to come out since you had before. Because like all I had to do was say like, hey mom, I'm like Dylan. She's like, oh, okay, cool. But like... I don't know. It was a really kind of awkward situation.
That's how you came out? I'm like Dylan?
Yeah, literally. No, so here's what happened.
So, yeah, that's exactly.
Here's what happened. So I was like, mom, like I want to go to Starbucks before she takes me to school. Since it was my freshman year, I couldn't drive. And I finally get the guts to say it. I'm like, hey mom, I have something to tell you. I'm like Dylan. She's like, oh, okay, so you like girls? And I'm like, yeah, or something like that. I don't know. It might not have been exactly that. I can't really remember.
Well, she didn't say you like boys.
Well, no.
Because that's more like me.
Yeah. I was made sure I was kind of close to school so that I could just like get out of the situation as fast as I possibly could. But yeah, so we got to school. She dropped me off. I was early for once in my life. I closed the door and went on my way.
So you had Starbucks? Came out and then went to school.
Yeah, and then my day just went on. And it actually wasn't a bad day. I didn't think about it the rest of the day, so. But I don't think coming out was a big deal to me, though.
It was for me, just because the religious part of it. Growing up in a religious house,
mm-hmm.
It wasn't exactly accepted. I mean, it was scary. I really was scared.
Which actually, what's like so interesting is like when we would go to church, I don't remember them saying anything about like being gay or like, just at the church that we were at. And I don't remember anything.
Did you ever go to our father's house? The other church that we used to go to? With
Seth
and stuff?
Yeah, I was really little.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't remember.
It was that church.
Yeah. I think we're finished.
There's two of those.
I know.
Scissoring, does she like scissoring? I don't know. She doesn't want to answer that.
That's not really like...
a thing?
No, it's not.
Okay, that's just about it.
It's just an odd question. Oh, man.
Thank you for the questions. Mm-hmm. Thank you for doing this video, Jess.
Yeah.
It was fun, though, right?
It was.
We kind of, like, connected a little mm-hmm. bit. Had some laughs. So. If you're not subscribed to this channel, feel free to subscribe. We want our subscribers to go up, 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 up. Chris and I have merch now. Go check out the merch. Fire us.
And Jess.
Love you long time.
Yeah. That was fun.
If you want to go check out my sister Jessica's Instagram, the link is in the description below. And we also have a Patreon page.
So please consider supporting us on Patreon.